Okay, my name is Major Russell Conte, R-U-S-S-E-L-L-C-O-N-T-E. I am from the New Hampshire State Police Operations Bureau, and I'm here just to update the earlier press conference. I'd like to thank you for coming, and lastly, I'd like to thank you immensely on behalf of the State Police and the family of the victim for your assistance in putting that photograph out. The photograph that was released this morning, where it was a vehicle of interest in this fatality, and that would be the vehicle that lost the wheel. That is, in fact, the vehicle. We have located it in the state of Maine. So that was, in fact, the vehicle, and your assistance is greatly appreciated. The other things I want to share with you is this accident, just to recap, happened about 8:10 this morning. We did release earlier that it was a state police employee operating an unmarked cruiser. It was, in fact, Colonel Robert Quinn, the director of the New Hampshire State Police. He was operating that cruiser northbound on his way to headquarters. And at that point in time, southbound was the vehicle in question. And the wheel came off of the trailer, crossed over the Jersey barrier, median area. And the first thing it did was strike Colonel Quinn's cruiser on the front quarter panel, driver's side. After that, it then bounced off, ricocheted into the southbound lane, and then it struck the vehicle, and the victim was killed. At that point, both vehicles came to rest against the Jersey barrier, short distance from there. So I'd like to turn it over to County Attorney Scott Murray for some comments on the status of the criminal investigation. We are, in fact, as we speak, working with the Maine State Police on this, and appreciate greatly their assistance in helping us locate the vehicle in question and the operator.
Thank you, Major. As indicated, my name is Scott Murray, the Merrimack County Attorney. My office would have the primary responsibility for reviewing the state police investigation, making a determination as to whether any charges are appropriate. As indicated by the Major, we're currently working with New Hampshire State Police and Maine State Police in order to secure some more information about this so that we can get an accurate assessment as to what happened, make a determination as to whether any criminal charges are appropriate. We are currently attempting to secure the necessary paperwork to bring the vehicle back to New Hampshire for a thorough investigation and an analysis of the vehicle. That's a critical part of the criminal investigation. Beyond that, I can't really comment. It is an ongoing criminal investigation at this point, and we are constrained to some extent with respect to what we can say. I would take any questions if anyone has.
Do you have some idea of what led you to this vehicle? Was it a tip from the public, or was it your own?
Yeah, it was actually a combination, and it was a combination of eyewitnesses that we have, calls. We had numerous calls from the public. We also asked for the assistance of trucking companies to review their records, and it was a combination. By the time we got finished this morning with speaking with all of you, we had already had a lot of calls.
So,
you know what? It was numerous, numerous calls. Your assistance, it was... I can't give an exact number, but there was numerous calls, and that helped us to get to pinpoint where the vehicle might be, and then to actually find the company and the driver, and that's Alan Condon of Oakfield, Maine. I also you have this in your press release, but also to note that the Miss Anderson Baker was in fact the victim of the fatality. She was killed when the tire came through and struck her vehicle at approximately 8:10 this morning.
Where did you find the truck? Was it at a residence, or was it at another rest stop?
It was off. It had gotten off of an exit into a rest area, basically a trucking area. The Maine State Police, after we had information that it could in fact be a Maine company, they in fact went out and actually found the truck, based on not only the description, but the information that we had and the calls that we had. So it was found off of the interstate, Maine, the Maine Turnpike.
There was some information that said the truck driver may not have been known that he threw his tire there, or that the vehicle had come off. Is it still pointing toward that direction, that he was unaware of why
he
kept going?
That would obviously be an issue that we'd have to resolve in reaching a determination with respect to whether criminal charges are appropriate. So I don't know that we really want to comment on that.
Right.
So no charges are being filed at this time?
Not at this point. The matter is still under investigation.
Has Maine State Police talked to the driver yet? Got that story?
Maine State Police has had contact with both the company and the driver, but we're not going to comment on any statement. They're in the process of working with the New Hampshire State Police on the investigation. It's ongoing.
So here we have a modular home in the back of a rig traveling down the highway from New Hampshire to Maine, missing one of its wheels. Are we lucky that there wasn't something more serious that happened here?
I don't think there's any question that this could have been much more catastrophic. I mean, we have loss of life, and our thoughts and certainly our prayers are with the family. Colonel Quinn, certainly he could have been injured, but I can tell you that from the first moment that I spoke with him this morning, his concern was to the family, and also that we follow our own rules and regulations, and that is what we release as far as state vehicles, who's operating them. He wanted to make sure we followed our own rules. So that was the hesitation we had this morning. And I think that really followed true with putting the scope of this and pinpointing it onto the victim and trying to find this truck. We wanted everything pointed at that. And again, we're indebted to all of you for that, but we wanted to make sure that that all of our effort went into finding this truck and this driver.
Can you see how big this wheel was? It wasn't just correct?
Right. It's a trailer for modular homes. Right? It's a heavy equipment trailer. So you're talking about a wheel much larger than a vehicle, than a regular car tire. And the other thing to be noted is that when the wheel came off, I believe that it also came off as the whole modular unit. So there was a braking system attached to it. So the mass and inertia that the wheel had, you know, was considerable. That's ongoing. We certainly, in conjunction with advice from the county attorney's office, we'll be looking at all of that. We will autopsy the truck, get a thorough look at everything involved. But it's something we're not going to comment on. But it is ongoing, and I assure you, we'll leave no stone unturned in this.
Any idea when the truck could return? You said you're working on paperwork right now.
That requires a fair amount of paperwork between here and Maine, but we are attempting to expedite it currently. We have an assistant county attorney and state troopers working on it right now.
Did the colonel have any idea where the wheel came from?
I can tell you that he was operating northbound. No, he didn't know just based on a short conversation. And obviously the impact was pretty great. He was affected by it. And he immediately immediately became aware of the accident that happened in the southbound lane. He immediately stopped. He called for assistance. He called for medical assistance. He saw the seriousness of it and immediately went to the victim. So he acted as any state trooper would and wanted to make sure that this was handled like we've handled everything. All the accidents and incidents we investigate every day.
How quickly after that did you know you were searching for this white truck?
We knew almost immediately. It was probably within the first half hour. It is the information age, and we had people that were calling and saying, "Hey, I saw this. I noticed this white truck." It was shortly thereafter that one of our troopers, who was working on Interstate 89 in Lebanon, at a construction detail, and he had his emergency lights activated for safety, not only of his construction personnel but his own. And we have camera systems in the cruisers, and when the emergency lights are activated, the cameras come on. So he knew it's a possibility they came, that this truck may have come by me. He had photographs. That is the still photograph that we shared with all of you in the media that you put out, and was in fact the truck. I mean, we felt pretty strongly based on time and distance, based on descriptions we had from eyewitnesses, but it was just great work all the way around. But in the end, it certainly never will overshadow that someone lost their life out here on a beautiful day on a highway going to work.
Major, I heard that Colonel Quinn had some pretty heroic driving when that tire came up.
There's no question. Colonel Quinn leads from the front. There's no doubt that that he could have certainly lost control of his vehicle after the impact. He didn't. And obviously his first thoughts weren't of himself, but of the victim. So he did what we all did as troopers. And he's a trooper through and through, and he acted in a way that certainly got this thing off immediately, you know, off in the right direction. And I think we could all be proud of that. Proud that he's not only the director, but part of the state police.
Speaking of the victim, have you been in contact with your family, and how are you thinking about them all?
We've certainly made notification with the family. The state police has a peer counseling unit that we use in critical situations. Our peer counselors have not only been in contact with the family, but in contact with family members and members of the division. So at this point, you know, that is something I don't think anybody can ever expect. And I don't think there is any easy way not only to deliver a message, but to accept it. So you have to, you know, this is fresh in everybody's mind. This happened a few hours ago. We are fortunate that we stand here today knowing who it was, what happened, and that we acted appropriately and as swiftly as we could.
Where did Major, who owns the truck? Is it Condon or Crawford Homes?
I believe the truck is a company truck.
Company truck?
Yes.
Major, did the colonel call in his own accident?
Yes, sir, he did. He called in, basically he called in the accident of the victim. And after the fact, and when we got it, we found out his vehicle was struck. So he was able to get all the emergency services headed out here. And we had troopers here immediately. There was a couple of construction setups, and those troopers left. So yeah, it was immediate.
I mean, you got on his radio, and he must be like, you know, unit one to head. What does he say?
Yeah.
You don't hear that every day.
Right, you don't hear that every day. You certainly hear him on the radio every day, but he called in, and he said he had an accident and that he needed assistance, and he gave it, you know, basically a description of how serious the accident was and got medical assistance coming, and he did what troopers do every day, and I'm sure he'd be the first one to tell you that.
Travis, is just a freak accident that unfolded in a matter of seconds.
Yeah, a matter of seconds, absolutely. I think that this is, as I said this morning, we have absolutely no evidence that anybody could have avoided this. Meaning both Colonel Quinn and the victim. So the reality is, this is a freak occurrence. It is unfortunately debris. It's a piece of equipment that flew off a truck, and the rest of it's left to, you know, why did that happen? But what happened out here, I think we've pretty much cleared up, and there's quite a bit of work for the county attorney's office to do, and you know, we'll be vigilant in finding out everything we can. I'm not going to comment on that, only that we are still ongoing with the investigation. I got a quick look at the vehicle, and there is front-end damage to it. I couldn't see exactly what it was, but obviously she was driving at the time when she was injured. So,
did she lose her life from the wheel hitting, or did she kind of lose control on that?
I think at this point in time, we're going to work with the medical examiner's office to the extent of injuries, but I think it's pretty safe to say that wheel had a lot to do with her injuries.
And do you know which rest area in Maine they found the truck?
I don't know the exact rest area, no.
And do you know, was it just chance that it was Colonel Quinn's car that was struck, or did he see that object coming and try to get between it and the traffic?
I can tell you that I guess Colonel Quinn did see the tire. He didn't know where it came from, and he said it unfolded pretty quickly. But I think he probably didn't have a whole lot of time to react, only to maintain the control of his own vehicle after the collision of this wheel and his own vehicle.
The truck driver called in his own accident, or if Colonel
Quinn called? No, he asked me if Colonel Quinn did, and the answer was yes, he did.
The truck driver didn't call?
No.
You said this morning that witnesses said the truck driver may have stopped after the tolls. Do you have any update on that?
Yeah, the same information that we got the same information more than once today, that the vehicle went up, the truck in question went through the toll booth, and then later on did stop. The one thing that was additionally that we learned shortly after our initial investigation this morning is that the vehicle did have an escort. It was not a police escort. It was not a state police escort, but it did have an escort vehicle behind it. So you had another vehicle, and there's usually radio contact, but it did not have a police escort. And that's something we learned shortly after the press conference this morning. No, it has to meet a certain requirement of width and length. They do have permits. Many of these companies, and many of them, get an annual permit that's done through the Department of Transportation and Motor Vehicle. And in this case, he did not need a police escort, but needed an escort vehicle.
Will you also be talking to the driver of that escort vehicle to make sure that they didn't miss anything or have any derelictions?
The
We will endeavor to interview every witness that we can find so that we can make a final determination as to what happened here and what should be done about it.
Sorry to cover this already, but did the escort or the driver know something had gone wrong?
That's what we're trying to find out. I mean, we will talk to everyone, and it's just too early to tell. We're just thrilled that that we got your assistance today and that we found this vehicle.
And how long after the accident did you track down the vehicle? I mean, how many hours did that take this morning? So was that you track down the vehicle?
I would say that we came up with the vehicle approximately 2.5, 3 hours ago. So it was after the press release went out, after we had the press conference, the picture went out, and it was after that. So just probably within the last 2.5 to 3 hours. Roughly, which by investigative standards is pretty much light speed. So we're very happy on that.
Now, does that escort usually drive behind a vehicle like this? Where are they in relation to?
Yeah, the rules for escort vehicles is on interstates, they drive behind. And then on secondary roads, many times you'll see that they'll be ahead of a wide load to make sure that people kind of move over. But on the interstate system, they always travel to the rear.
And have you made contact with the driver of that escort yet?
As the county attorney said, we're not going to release anything, but we are going to talk to everyone.
What kind of criminal charges could the driver be facing if they are to be
fired? I don't know that we'd want to speculate on that at this point. I can say that in New Hampshire, there is an absolute responsibility to stop after you're involved in an accident. As I indicated this morning, what we're concerned about is what happened afterwards, primarily from the legal perspective, and that's what we're looking into now.
We're looking into that to make sure. I don't think we have any direct information right now, but we are looking into that.
And was the escort directly behind that truck?
That's part of the investigation on the location of where everything was. I thank you very much. I don't know if it's directly behind, but thank you for coming. And again, thank you for the help.
Can